Corsair has done the unthinkable. They've released a new CPU cooler? Wait a minute, how is that unthinkable? Corsair has a dominant presence in this space with AIOs, custom loop components, fans, and even their own line of thermal paste. What's missing? Well, how about a modern tower-style CPU cooler with that Corsair touch? Well, consider this missing piece found. This is the Corsair A115, and we're gonna be looking at how it performs, how easy it is to install, and what Corsair did to set it apart from some really compelling air coolers. Now, if you've pushed aside the idea of using tower-style air coolers or relegated them to budget builds and low-power PCs, it's time that you gave them a second look. In the past year, we put a number of tower coolers up against each other, and we see them go punch for punch with AIOs, and in a number of cases, come out on top in both performance and value. And to this challenge, Corsair has finally answered the call. Now, Corsair has made tower-style coolers in the past, but the most recent one, the A500, was released about 4 years ago. That's like ancient times. Now, considering the number of AIOs that have been released in the same window of time, that's not a whole lot of love for air coolers. But that drought is over, and we have new young blood, a new contender waiting to cut its teeth, Corsair's A115. Or A115, I don't know, but both sound cool. This aspiring air cooler hit the market on January 16th, a day before my birthday, by the way, at a retail price of $99, and with everything we've seen, it's gunning for the top. Now, before we get too ahead of ourselves, let's look at where the A115 falls into the current market of tower coolers. For comparison, the price tag positions the A115 right next to a few incredible air coolers, the Deepcool Assassin 4, and the Cooler Master MA824, both coming in at $99.99, as well as the Be Quiet Dark Rock Pro 4 at $89.99. If you've watched our Air Cooler Olympics, which you should watch right after this, it's right here, you could probably recognize that two of these coolers did extremely well, and one of them walked away as king of the coolers. So to say that the Corsair A115 has some pretty stiff competition is an understatement. What isn't an understatement, though, is that we're so glad that you're here and learning about tech alongside us. And if you like the idea of being educated and entertained along the way, you should slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and ring that notification bell so that you don't miss a video like this one. And I'm not joking around when I say that we have some really neat tech, and we're gonna be talking about all of that this year. So, we know about the price and where it falls in the market, but what makes the Corsair A115 stand out? Well, let's take a look at it. It's just a boring box. As we said before, the A115 is a tower-style cooler, but this cooler elevates the design by pairing six 6mm heat pipes and 90 serrated and nickel-plated cooling fins with a massive copper cold plate. I have to call this out because sometimes you get an itty-bitty cold plate that barely covers the CPU, but this thing is like a Snuggie. Except instead of keeping the heat in, it draws it out. Thanks to this design, Corsair is confident that the A115 can support CPUs up to a 250-watt TDP. So that includes AMD CPUs up to and including the Ryzen 9 7950X, and also Intel's 14th generation core processors up to the Intel Core i9-14900K. No, we're not talking about running at max boost with all that wacko motherboard stuff. And if you are gonna be doing any rendering and things, I don't know if I'd recommend the A115. But to be safe, if you really wanted to use some great CPUs and do everything, the 14700K and maybe the 7900X may be better options here. Assisting with the cooling task are two of Corsair's 140mm AF140 Elite fans. These fans provide a massive amount of air movement, up to 84.5 CFM. And with the help of all those cooling fins, they are super quiet. So it's a lot of air, just really quiet. Now, according to Corsair, their operation shouldn't be any louder than 34 decibels. That's somewhere between a whisper and the sound of a fridge running. Now, if that wasn't impressive enough, the A115 or A115 has another trick up its sleeve, the fan mount on a slide and lock mechanism to help builders who are concerned with RAM clearance or who want to be precise when directing airflow. Not only that, the A115 comes with a third rail should you want to get creative with fan placement. That is, if your motherboard allows it. Now, we weren't able to test to see if more fans are better on an air cooler, but it's cool that you have some extra support. Speaking of support, what kind of CPUs does the Corsair A115 support? If you're looking at building an Intel-based system, the A115 supports the modern LGA 1700 sockets for their current generation of Intel processors. So that means 12th, 13th, and 14th gen, as well as LGA 1200 for 10th and 11th gen, and LGA 115X. So that's like back in like Jesus days CPUs, right? Now for AMD systems, the A115 supports CPUs on both AM4 and AM5. So basically, the Corsair A115 supports most modern day CPUs. Now installation of the A115 feels very familiar if you've installed a tower style cooler before. Like most tower coolers, the A115 has different retention brackets and standoffs for Intel and AMD, but Corsair makes securing this simple with an additional standoff on the brackets themselves to guide the cooler into place. Now, if you're installing the A115 on an Intel platform, Corsair includes a handy dandy backplate to make sure the cooler lands precisely where it needs to be. But with AMD's AM4 or AM5 motherboards, you'll remove the clip bracket, but use the existing backplate. Once you have the backplate installed or any unnecessary hardware removed, you'll choose the brackets and standoffs that are right for your socket, mount them all nice and neat to the backplate standoff, and then line the A115 up with the posts on the bracket arms, and then just fly it in. Once it's all lined up, there are two capture screws and tension springs to tighten things down, and congratulations, throw a party, do a little dance, because you've just installed a heatsink. Huzzah! Now next up, it's time to install the fans. The fans utilize two slim side and lock brackets apiece to hold them in place. These brackets have a left and right indicator on them. Once you have them aligned on the appropriate side of the fans, you use the screws to mount the brackets in place before you gingerly slide them into place. And they do glide with a fair amount of ease. They're so graceful. Now there is a slight hitch with these brackets, but we'll talk about that in a bit. Well, we now know what we're looking at. The big question is, does it work? Well, let's look at the numbers. At CPU idle, the A115 matches the average temperature of Noctua's NHU12A and Be Quiet's Dark Rock 4 at 35 degrees Celsius. In our charts, these three are throwing hands at each other, all being in third place, but this is about to change. When we jump up to CPU load test, we crank CPU usage up to 100%, and the Corsair A115 showed us its skills with an average temperature on the cooler side of 82 degrees Celsius. With this score, the A115 pushed the Deepcool Assassin 4 and Noctua's NHD15 aside, clawing its way into second place. And for comparison, the Cooler Master MA824, our reigning king of coolers, held the CPU temp at 80 degrees Celsius. And this is the cooler the A115 is gunning for in gaming. During our gaming test, the A115 averaged CPU temperatures of 57 degrees Celsius, positioning right next to the Noctua NHD15 again, but losing out once more to the MA824 by a single degree. So close. A great all-around showing for the A115 though, and we can't knock its performance, that's for sure. Now that we've seen how it performs, let's look at the relative value of the A115. It's been a minute since our last CPU cooler video, so here's a reminder on the math. We take the retail price and divide it by the difference between the CPU thermal max, which in this case is 100 degrees Celsius, and the temperature under full load, which is 82 degrees Celsius. So in this case, we take $99, which is the retail price, and divide it by 18, which is the difference, and that gives us dollars per degree of cooling value, which we can then score and compare, with the lowest number being better. In the case of the Corsair A115, the score is currently marked at 5.5, which is neck and neck with the Deepcool Assassin 4. Not bad company to keep, but not enough to dethrone the MA824 at just under 5. Alrighty, so you're probably thinking, Robey, the performance, the pricing, this is way too close. Help me, I need to know which one to choose. Well, when you look at the landscape of tower coolers and where the A115 falls, specifically alongside the Assassin 4 and the MA824, there are not bad choices among them. If you like the overall aesthetics of this crazy cooler, then go for it. I mean, it's attractive. I date it. However, we do like a number of things about the A115 over the others, including the flexibility of fan placement, giant cold plate, and the ease of installation. We can't overemphasize the importance of the option to swap fan orientation or the compatibility to slide fan height. This feature alone makes the A115 a super versatile CPU cooler if you're worried about the fans clearing your RAM, VRM, or I/O shielding. Now, with that said, we do have to mention a few things to pay attention to. Thing number one, because Corsair is using 140 millimeter fans, they have a super snug fit. This is really, really important to know when you're pairing a CPU cooler with motherboard and RAM. While there is some flexibility here, if the RAM or VRM heatsinks are super chunky, you might have some difficulty getting the fans to sit flush with the main body of the cooler. Also, if your motherboard has a super thick I/O shield, you can forget about moving a fan to the back position. Now, in our build, the A115, we made sure to use low profile DDR5, but even then, we had the fan sticking out about an eighth of an inch from the cooler. As you saw from our test, this didn't have a significant impact on the A115's performance, but for some of us, having that fan stick out really, really bothered us. Again, it's not a huge deal breaker here, but you should be aware that even with this versatile adjustment on the cooler, you still need to use low profile, non-RGB memory. You also want to be conscious of your motherboard's I/O shield and VRM heatsinks if you want to use the A115 successfully. Thing number two, installing the fan brackets was a bit confusing and Corsair's labeling didn't help. Okay, this one, it's a bit trippy, and sure, we might be overthinking this, we do that from time to time, but the labeling on the Corsair A115 could be better. Let me explain. Each of the fan brackets is labeled either left or right. Simple enough, right? Now, on the cooler itself, where the brackets connect, those two are labeled left and right. Now, does left match up with left and right with right? No, that would make sense. No, not at all. Each lines up with the opposite, so left is with right, and right is with left, and right is wrong, and left is right. Anyway, from a certain standpoint, I understand what Corsair was going for. It's just a bit more complicated than it needs to be. Maybe they could have used like matching symbols instead. Now, even with these considerations, we really loved everything that Corsair delivered with the A115. High performance fans, mounting that gives you room to play, a giant cold plate for maximum IHS coverage, the IHS Snuggie, I could go on. But what I'm really trying to say is that if you've had doubts about cooling capabilities of tower style coolers, the Corsair A115 is yet another example of an air cooler that does the job very well. And again, it creates simplicity and it also creates, I don't know, just ease to install. The A115 may not have taken the crown from the MAA24, but it did a fine job of keeping pace with it both in performance and in value. Now, if you're looking for an air cooler for your CPU in your next build, you really can't go wrong with Corsair's latest air cooler. Those were some of our thoughts on the Corsair A115 from Corsair, but we want to know what your thoughts down in the comments below. Did you like the number of times that I called it A115 and A115? Let me know what the number is down below. Also, we'd love to hear if you're gonna be using the Corsair A115 in your next build. Now, while you're down there, make sure you slap that subscribe button with that like button and ring that notification bell so that you get a notification each and every time we post a video like this right here on Robeytech. We also have an amazing Discord community with some of the most helpful and amazing people that love to talk about tech. So you might wanna just learn something new, and you know what, you might make a friend. Anyway, guys, join over there, discord.gg/Robeytech, and make sure you check us out at Robeytech absolutely everywhere. Thank you for watching this one, and we look forward to seeing you on the next one.